that's a good.
So I was saying that Python support, what it's doing today, shouldn't be broken by any of the stuff that we're proposing.
I don't think it has. No, I don't think it has to be changed for that.
Yeah. So
everything has to be done in dhpython now.
Yes.
And that's the problem because it is, you know.
Maybe can you go back to Python?
Joy has refuses to include non-parallel stuff into their program.
Yeah.
Let's just make a depend on Python.
You can write that. I'm faster at writing the Perl loop than the Python.
Of course you're faster because I have now, because if you start to work on that, I have to do more of this stuff.
Okay. So basically that means that Python support will continue to exist. Nobody has to do any transitions as a result of that. They can continue using that. Python Central, we're going to work on specking out the, actually getting that implemented. And so by Saturday, Python defaults should be converted. We should be telling people to upload the new stuff. Is that right?
Let's see.
Okay.
You're faster. Okay, so first, as from my point of view, let's just say thank you to you all for this good discussion. I think we made a major step forward. And now the question is, do we have other Python topics, or are we 1¼ hour of discussions here now? So,
yeah.
I think it's just enough. Do we have more Python stuff you want to discuss about than this very important part of
PD? We have this
I don't get what you mean.
Yes, done by Python support.
Is an issue, is it? Matthias?
Well, there was a discussion to not compile to optimize bytecode that will be implemented by Python sampling, so that I have a config file which just specifies which bytecode compilation should be done.
Okay, which does currently the maintainer ships do things?
Right, that's done.
Which slows down installation. It's fragment, it needs to be cleaned up. Python itself adds PIC files anywhere it can. I do not think this is a real ideal situation, actually.
I don't see.
Also
could you describe the problem? I don't see the problem.
Are you objecting to the PIC files completely?
Well, not completely, because I recognize the need for some certain applications that can benefit hugely from it. But I think that the management of the files are not really optimal. And I mean, this slows down compilation for very few benefits, and I think we should make it optional. And definitely make Python itself not add them at runtime when you run something.
Oh, you're saying that Python, when it runs and doesn't find one, should be fixed so that it doesn't try to create one.
Yes.
Okay, that's the problem.
Important if you have different Python versions, because then it will, if you have one application using one application using the other, they'll constantly create one for the other version.
This is something that can be entirely done with Python support, because it could make the bytecode creation optional and still keep the bytecode removal. So if some program creates the .pyc file, it will still be removed.
But he's saying that what we need is an interpreter fix so that Python, the program itself, when you call it, doesn't try to create the
As far as I understood, as the Matthias said, it's just that what happened on installation is that you just put the binary, the package in the symlinked to the different locations so that each interpreter could have its own bytecode file.
Right.
Yeah, it's not a problem.
And we could, indeed for us, would use the PIC files in a separate directory, or like a kind of fast cache something.
See, I think you may be misremembering the discussion about PYO files, because what happens with those is it tries to build those every time if you're running with the optimization options turned on, but Python effectively today doesn't do any optimization, so what happens is it spends this time to optimize it, creates a file which is identical to the PYC it already has, and ends up running slower as a result of that than if it hadn't done it at all, because it's got more start time. PYC files, I think what we're doing today is pretty good. I don't
understand the argument, because if I start the Python interpreter without -O, Python C fast are considered to follow me. If I start
right.
with minus O,
mm-hmm.
Pi O fast are considered.
Right.
So it only saves some time on package installation.
Okay.
Not on starting packages. So ICP
for
that? Yeah, I would like to add my support to the interpreter change so that in situations when you really don't want the compiled Python microcode files, such as in an embedded environment, where disk space is sort of difficult to get, it would be good to be able to have this. But certainly, by default, I think we should compile Python microcode files upon installation. And if Python support can have a configuration file somewhere where we can remove this, then have
very
it.
Easy.
Yes.
Something
good.
That can be added.
Well,
I have already removed the compilation of PYO files because, as Steve explained, they are not used. They are used, but they are not useful. So, by not creating these files, we are affecting people who run Python minus big O. But anyway, there's no point in using this option because there are no optimizations.
Well, if somebody wants to recompile or compile by compile or his Python fast with minus O, he can do it.
Yeah.
That's
why there are still removal cases against removal.
Right.
I think it would be great to have a user configurable when you want a BIC fast. I mean, BIO, I think that issue is indeed non-existent anymore. That's already solved. But the BIC fast, yeah, well, if nobody else thinks, yeah, Lars does.
I think the common case that we want to optimize for is that we do want the PYC files to be pre-compiled to save the startup time.
Yes.
That's the common case, and if Python support can add an option to let you skip writing those out to disk on package install.
Can you also get the small interpreter fix to not save the PIC file when programs are run normally, in case we ever have a root user who ever runs a Python program?
Matthias, what do you think about that?
I did.
That's the thing now is if somebody does go and remove the PYC files because they don't want them on their system, if somebody runs a Python program as root, the PYC files are created.
Wait.
Is that a change that can be made to Python that you would agree with? Does someone need to file a bug?
Well, if you do that change, I think it's I don't see a real benefit.
I would want, if I have a situation like a very, very small computer, then I don't want the microcode file, and I don't want the files to be changed randomly when I run programs.
There's one very old patch which allows compilation or writing of the bytecode files in another location. Not sure if that can be modified to not at all write the bytecode files.
If I write the batch, did you accept it?
I would prefer it if it's accepted upstream first and then take it over to the Debian package.
Yeah.
Okay, I think there's an argument to say it's good at upstream first with such changes. Reasonable.
I think this patient should perhaps be smart to limit itself to only slash user the iFile, because if an administrator or someone is root test in one other direction, you probably want to maintain the default behavior to not defer too much from upstream and limit it to the Debian packages itself. Debian packages which have the option to have PIC files if the administrator wishes so via Python support. So that is configurable whether you want PIC files during installation time, and the Python interpreter will not create them anyway if you indicate that you do not want them, but that the behavior is the same for non-packaged Python files.
Now I have another administrative question here. I can see a few people who are just about to get up and go out. So my question is, do we need to discuss if this here is full out, or could you just, so you see, go to get a beer? Would that be okay?
Yeah,
I think we will be
now
in 5 minutes or something.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, but I think we should give the people who want to get out the chance to do that before. Hassan, please continue.
But is there anything which you want to say about your opinion about the...
Well, one last thing is I only would prefer to only have to support one packaging aid. So let's make it either Python support or either Python sample. I don't think these are two things, two implementations which do the same thing. And well, I don't mind. I just did try to complete the PySample implementation because, I didn't see any progress with the Python support implementation. So I have no problems to drop PySample, but it should be a complete implementation. And it's
so it sounds like Python support can implement everything with PySample. Taking information from the control fields instead of roles.
As long as it concerns Python modules, I think it does everything Steve requested.
Are you willing to extend it to include support for the C modules? Because we need a solution for that as well. And he's saying it's better if we just have the one solution, one implementation, so that they don't diverge.
I don't think there is a need for supporting C modules in Python support.
We need to have something that provides,
yes, that the provider done in DH, at the DH Python level.
Okay, so
DH Python would have to generate a new Python column provides.
Okay, so if DH Python is the common implementation, mm-hmm. is that?
Well, if it can handle all things, for example, does. Well.
Although there's one thing Python support is missing, it is support from Python 2.x packages. For example, when Python 2.4 is installed for the first time, it has to signal Python support that, hey, I'm here. So you can look, you can build your modules for that new version.
Mm-hmm. The interpreter packages do not have hooks for Python support.
Yes.
So installing a new interpreter does
it's
not generate
just a matter of coding update Python modules without any arguments in the post-installation and post-removal scripts.
Well, you keep your own database of Python faults. That's ugly, but we did talk about it.
I think it's better if it's electronically.
Well, if we have that information and we should use that information in our packaging system, which we have in our packaging system.
Does this come back to the part where we talked about using dpackage to query
right.
versions from inside of a maintainer script?
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hey, we need books.
Okay. So we are done.
Do we all agree that we can make Python 2.4 migration before implementing all of this? Because it will take some time.
Well, it's done. Python sample does
it. Sorry?
It's done. Python sample does it.
Can you simply recall your work on people
I wanted to ask.
Yeah, so I did my work for my article, but.
Well,
so
I think what my understanding, okay, perhaps it's a good idea to summarize the discussion again. My understanding of what we discussed here is that we have a solution that is nice for the long term, and where Steve and Doku volunteer to maintain, and then I basically volunteer to kick them to
it's
do it really.
Right.
to make sure that it exists
in verse.
He maintained it, and I will make sure that we do it this week. So, and if it happens this week, I don't think that is a bad issue. I think we are fast enough. And if not, we can still reconcile it. But my understanding is that we are near enough, or that is so that only tweaks in some days necessary, so it could be quite fast.
Yes.
Is that understanding correct?
It sounds like we have a pretty strong consensus on what the solution is supposed to be.
Yeah.
And then I would really go for the solution and try to save the effort needed for an old style Python before the decision. And if it doesn't work, we can still reconsider what to do if it breaks. But we have to do that anyways. If we have some idea what we want to do for the release schedule and it doesn't work, we always have to say, okay, it breaks, what do we do now? But the first thing is we want to fix it.
I'm sorry, are you saying that Python defaults change should be delayed while we work on this? Is that what you said?
To be more specific, how about we say that we work on this week?
And then we send the review how far we are.
And no, we don't review how far we are. By the week after DevConf is finished, we start the 2.4 transition, and if Python Central is not working, we keep doing the current thing. But Python Central should be working. This seems like we should be able to do it in Python support. If we can merge the two, that's great. If we have two separate things that work the same way, then
our vision is that we do is with Python before transition with the Python Central, and if it doesn't work, we will merge the old way. Something like that.
Yes. Right, but I don't think we have to follow it. I don't think we will either.
Well, I hope that we can do this with Python Central. That's our really my wish. Is that okay for you?
Right.
So when will the Python defaults change actually get uploaded? Because I don't want to get in a situation where we have lots of Python packages that have to be transitioned and no work is being done on them to convert them to Python support.
Well, let's focus on PyTorch having Python Central or Python support ready. Let's upload it to the repository so that package maintainer actually can start converting their packages. Mm-hmm. So we have some more test cases. And then, do the transition.
Right.
Maybe not on DevConf.
No, like do the transition a week after that everyone's coming back from DevConf or something like that. But get the Python Central or Python support.
I just want to make sure we don't have a realistic requirement that 80% of Python packages must be converted before we start the Python 2.4 transition, because then it's like, no, the transition is happening, the maintainers need to get off their butts and get this done.
Basically, I understand that if packages have to be touched, they would have been be touched for an old style 2.4 transition anyways.
Right.
So that's in the last time to do the work, which is okay, I think.
So we will see the only benefit if we switch from 2.4 to 2.5, but maybe not now.
Yeah.
But that's okay.
Because more of these packages will be able to move into testing, and we've been done with those packages for transitioning before.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
So
disentangle the transition that way
from Python.
Okay.
So you maintainers won't see it, but Steve, AJ, and I will see it.
The maintainers will see it, so.
But different.
Either way, with the new Python model team, we can always convert the package even when we have nothing special to do. I mean, if we don't have a new Python version.
Okay, but I think we are now a little done this year, and we have a lot of things to work, discuss elsewhere on the Python stuff. And yeah, thank you all for coming and for this good discussion.